first, second lesson. Joseph text is from 2 Corinthians chapter 5, verse 17.
Our first Bible lesson is taken from Matthew chapter 6, from verse 33 to 34. But seek ye first the kingdom of God and his righteousness, and all those things shall be added unto you. Take therefore no thoughts for the morrow, for the morrow shall take thoughts for the things of itself. Sufficient unto the day is the evil thereof. In the name of our Lord Jesus Christ.
And the second Bible lesson comes from Colossians 2, from verse 6 to 7. As ye have therefore received Christ Jesus the Lord, so walk ye in him, rooted and built up in him, and established in the faith as ye have been taught, abounding therein with thanksgiving. In the name of our Lord Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Our golden text is taken from 2 Corinthians chapter 5, verse 17. Therefore, if any man be in Christ, he is a new creature. All things are passed away. Behold, all things are become new. In the name of our Lord Jesus Christ.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. The first and the second, and indeed the golden text, they are summary of the lesson the Father has prepared for you and I. So it is important that we pay attention. The first lesson is saying that we should seek first the kingdom of God. That means that we must please God, and then all other things will be added. Today is Choristers fellowship meeting with the Holy Father. And these are largely young brethren. And when young brethren look at the world, the complexities of the world, the challenges of the world, they begin to worry. They begin to worry. And so whatever the world may seem like, no matter how complex, no matter how hopeless the world may look at the moment, it's not for anybody to worry himself. You have a Father who definitely will make a way where there is none. He will do what he will do. So don't bother yourself about the challenges and difficulties in the world, about the hopeless situation of things, how uncertain things are. Don't just worry. But pay attention to spiritual things. Concentrate in doing the thing that will be pleasing unto God. For when God is pleased, when you seek after the righteousness of the kingdom, you will open the way. Those complexities, those uncertainties will become so very easy. Those things you look like, can I ever buy a car? Things are getting too expensive by the day. You will buy not just a car, you will buy cars by the grace of God, in the name of our Lord Jesus Christ. There is nobody that can do anything on his own. Just like Paul said in Philippians 4:13. Nobody can do anything on his own. Everything is by the grace of God. If God does not give the ability, he cannot do anything. If God gives the ability, he can do all things. Paul said in that Philippians 4:13, said, I can do all things through Christ Jesus, who have strengthened me. So, if you seek the kingdom of God first, if you seek to please God, If you follow God and work for God, and He is pleased, God will strengthen you to achieve every other thing you want in life. Every desire, it's possible that your desires can come true, your wishes can come true, your dreams will come true. But then it is required that you submit unto God. Submit unto God, do the work of God, seek after the righteousness of the kingdom. Do not follow others and behave the way they behave. Don't be crazy about making wealth quick. Because Proverbs said anybody in this life who tried to be rich quick will definitely destroy the time. Anybody in this life that you want to be rich quick, you will sell your heart. So nobody should try or attempt to be rich quick. Just wait for the will of God. But of importance is that do the work of God. Submit yourself unto God. Please God in the things you do. Follow after righteousness. Once you have done this, you see that first lesson, 6, the 34 says that, take no thought for tomorrow, for tomorrow shall take care of itself. So, as a growing person, as somebody with so much hope and expectation, do not bother about what tomorrow will be. Do not, never you bother at all. Just concentrate in pleasing God. Do the work of God. Be prayerful. What will be. Just be prayerful. Don't begin to engage your thoughts. Oh, tomorrow, how will tomorrow be? I want to get this, I want to get that, I want to. Brethren, all that you need to do is that seek ye first the kingdom of God, for all other things shall be added unto you. And that is to say that you must seek after kingdom righteousness. You must not behave unduly. You must behave and walk circumspectly. You must behave as a child of God. Be in the Spirit. Walk in the Spirit. Walk by faith, not by sight. In the name of our Lord Jesus Christ. There is really nothing that if the Father wants to give you, that He will not give you. There is something in that scripture that says that take no thought for tomorrow. For tomorrow shall take care of it. Because you do not create tomorrow. You don't have control over tomorrow. It's the Father that controls tomorrow. If there is anything that is uncertain, as any other, is tomorrow. There's always tomorrow. But what we don't know is we do not know the content of tomorrow. We don't know what tomorrow will bring. And because we don't know what tomorrow will bring, that's why we must submit ourselves to God, who create tomorrow and package it. For us, we only see that tomorrow has come. The troubles that come with the tomorrow, we don't know. The good thing that comes with the tomorrow, we don't know. So, why do you bother yourself over so much of what you want to achieve? You want to achieve this. Tomorrow you want to achieve this. You want to achieve this. Meanwhile, that tomorrow you are planning has its own wahala. It has its own trouble. It has its own uncertainties. Tomorrow has its own complexities. That tomorrow may come. Even the things you have planned all to get, you finally may lose. Instead of gaining, you lose. So you can see that it is not by man's efforts. It is not by your hard work. It is by the grace of God. So if you say that, don't bother about tomorrow, For tomorrow shall take care of itself. Believe it. And he said, do not struggle too much to say, I want to gain this, I want to gain that. First of all, submit yourself to God. Worship Him. Practice the teachings of God. Be prayerful. He will answer your prayers. He will give you everything that belongs to you. Everything you deserve will be given unto you. In the name of our Lord Jesus Christ. Read the second Bible lesson. Yes.
Very enough. Second Bible lesson. Colossians 6, verse 7. As ye have therefore received Christ Jesus the Lord, so walk ye in him, rooted and built up in him, and established in the faith, as ye have been taught, abounding therein with thanksgiving in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ.
As ye have therefore been called to serve, we have all been chosen. We are all called to service. Let us therefore receive the words as those who answered a call. Be rooted in the words of God. Do not be a floater. Don't be a floater at all. Be rooted in the words of God. Understand the words of God. Understand the will of God. Because man must do the will of God at all times. If you do not understand the will of God, you might not be able to do that which is good. So let us study to understand the will of God and then practice the will of God. Be rooted in that which you have been taught, that which you have learned, the doctrines of God, doctrines of brotherhood, practices, teachings. Hold on to this and practice them. If you practice them, it will be well with you. If you practice them, there is nothing difficult that you cannot have. There is no difficulty that you cannot have a way out of it. Because when you have pleased God, God is the one that settles all other things. He maketh a way. And so let us do that which is good. Having been called, be in the Spirit, walk in the Spirit, serve with the goal of your heart. And then submit yourself to it. Give yourself to reading and studying of the words of God, such that you become rooted and stabilized in faith. Being rooted and stabilizing in faith is part of seeking first the kingdom of God. Because the kingdom of God has doctrines. The kingdom of God has do's and don'ts. The kingdom of God has precepts. So you have to follow, and the totality of those kingdom requirements leads to righteousness. And so you must do what is the content, the practices, the expectation of the kingdom, and attend the godliness required of those who have been called into the kingdom, and then every other thing will be easy and certain for you to have. In the name of our Lord Jesus Christ. Read the golden text.
The text is taken from 2 Corinthians chapter 5, verse 17. Therefore, if any man be in Christ, he is a new creature. All things are passed away. Behold, all things are become new. In the name of our Lord Jesus Christ.
You know, Christian brethren, having been called by the Holy Father to serve, we are no longer old, but we have been made new by the teachings. What makes you new? What makes you a new person in faith is the gospel you have received. The teachings you have received makes you new. And so, if the gospel does not enter your heart and bear fruit, you are not a new creature. a new creature in somebody who, before receiving the word, was behaving somehow. Now that the word has been given unto the person is now reformed. The person now behaves differently. That is a new creature in Christ Jesus, based on the words. So even so, it is expected that each and every one of us who have heard of the Father, we must be new creatures by the words of the Olumba Olumba. Now that we have received the words of our Father, let us be new. For all things are passed away. All things are passed away. Everything has been made new. That is certainly where we are right now. We must behave as those who are new. New in heart. New in knowledge. New in the fear of God. New in worship. New in love. New in patience. New in endurance. New in tolerance. We must show that we have received this blessing. And all of this must be done. Anyone who feels that the gospel or the teaching of the Father cannot make you new, you are not a child of God. The words of God is to make us new, is to change us. Gospel is meant to change us. And the change that takes place as a result of the words of God is what makes you a new creature. And so let us think about these things. How many of us, having received the teachings of the Holy Father, have dropped certain characters, have dropped certain attitudes, have changed certain habits? If you have not changed your habits, attitudes, and characters on the basis of the gospel of the Olumba Olumba, it means that you are still living in the old world. It means that old things have not passed away in your life. You are still the old person that everybody used to know. But to those who have received the words and have submitted themselves to the words of God, and the words of God have made changes in their lives, they have become new to that extent. So it is expected that each and every one of us make effort to become new by the teachings of the Father. As those who are prepared for the kingdom, we are prepared for the kingdom. Accept to be new. Let the word of God renew your mind. Let it renew your mind. Improve on your character, improve on attitudes, improve on behavior. Let your light shine among men, that they will glorify your Father. Your light cannot shine if you are still carrying the old character. Your life will only shine if you allow gospel to overwhelm you and certain characters have changed, then your life will shine. Men will now, particularly those who knew you before, now see you after receiving gospel. They say, God is wonderful. There is no, if this man can change, it means that nobody cannot change. So, may people say, come, which church will you go? You see? So, gospel can change somebody's attitudes. That is what gospel is meant to do. It can change your character. And for us to be new in Christ, new in brotherhood, new in the Holy Father, we must change attitudes. You must work on your behavior. It's very, very important. Don't carry on the old character, the attitudes. Don't carry on. Just make change. Make a change. Be a new person. Be a new person in conduct, in character, in attitude, in behavior. Then the grace of God will be upon your life, even now and forevermore. Amen. You know, please, brethren, the world is not for the world. You have been letting me, Father, bless you for you now.